Hello, this video tutorial shows how to quickly create neat tables in WordPress. In order to do that, you need to install the Easy Table plugin in the first place. So you need to go to your WordPress dashboard, then go to Plugins and select Add New. Now enter the name of your plugin and click the Search Plugins button. Here is the plugin. Easy Table. Now click Install Now. Now you want to confirm that you want to install the plugin, so click the OK button. Then done, activate your plugin and expand the settings drop down menu in order to select Easy Table here. So click it. Now let's see how to use it. You can enter your data on one line as though you do it in your table row. For example, if I want to replace this word with something else, I just highlight it here and type in my custom content. For example, yes, now I click Update Preview, and here is the new piece of content. So that's how we can update your table. Make sure that you separate your data with the commas. As you can see, every single piece of content is separated by commas. So it works the same way on all the lines. Each line represents a row in your table. The first thing that you need to pay attention to is the Show Hide Help button. This option allows you to display quick tooltips that give you an idea what this specific option is all about. For example, if you roll over this question mark, you can see a tooltip. The same works here, here, and so on. If you disable it, you see the question marks, the question mark icons are gone, and you will be having a harder time understanding what the options are actually all about. Now let's see the rest of the options. Shortcode Tag. This tag specifies what should open your table in code. As you can see, the table over here opens with the table tag and closes with the closing table tag. So since you have table here, it means that you can open your table with a table tag and close it with the same tag. Actually, you can replace the shortcode tag with whatever word you wish. For example, stuff. Now save your changes. As you can see, the preview doesn't work because the plugin does not understand the table tag anymore. But if you enter stuff and click Update Preview, it's gonna work again. Anyways, I'm changing it back to table. And change the actual short code tag to table as well. Now I save my modifications so it's back to normal, and here we go. So now it says table again. Moving on, cell attribute tag. You can use the ATTR tag to set attributes for your cells, such as style, col span, row span, etc. Just like with table, you can replace ATTR with any other word that you see fit. But I'm not gonna do it now. Alright. Also render table and widget. This option allows you to show your stylish table even in your sidebar. Let's see how it works. Just tick the checkbox and hit the save button. Now, copy your table code from the test area window over here, and go to your widget where you want to use it. So I'm going to Appearance, Widgets. At this point, let's open our front end and see how it looks at this point. So the widget is blank, there is nothing. Now, let's go back to our dashboard. Now, use the text widget. Drag it to your sidebar. Let's give it a title, for example, table. And just paste the code we just copied. Now, save your changes. And refresh your front end. As you can see, the table works here. It's stylized and so on. Sure thing, you need to tweak the width, but the bottom line is that it works. Now let's go back to our dashboard and see the next feature. Only load JS CSS when in this condition. The option defines what kind of content the table plugin must work on. You may wanna enable it on all sorts of content because you never know where exactly you may need to use a table. Moving on, load script on footer. Since your JavaScript code loads before the head tag in your HTML page, it slows down your page. Thus, the rest of the page does not load as fast as it could. Other than that, a slow site is a really bad SEO signal, which can contribute to lower rankings for your site. You may need to enable the feature so that the table plugin loads after your actual content, so you want a ticket for that reason. Alright, the next feature is use table sorter. The table sorter option allows for sorting your table data. First off, you want to enable the feature by ticking the option here. Now, save your modifications. Now, you can sort your table data in either ascending or descending order by clicking your table headings. Let me show you how. Just like that. All right. Let's move to the next feature. Use TH, that is table headings, for the first row. You want to keep it unticked if you don't need table headings in your table. Before we do anything, let's take a look at our table. As you can see, the first row is the heading row and the words are actual headings. Now, let's untick the checkbox here and save our changes to see what exactly it does. As you can see, the headings are gone. I'm gonna enable it back. All right. The next feature is load CSS. You need to disable this option if you don't want to load any CSS with your table. Let's disable the functionality. Save the change. And see what happens. So, as you can see, it's a plain table, plain HTML table, no bells and whistles. It's not exactly what I want, so I'm gonna enable the option back. Alright, the next feature is table class. If you want to use your own class with your table, that's where you need to enter your class name. Right here. In case it's not something you want to do, just ignore the text field. Moving on, table width. As you might have guessed, the option allows you to specify your table width, but you don't want to rely on it too much because the value can be overridden by CSS in the actual code. Now, table border. The table border option allows you to set your table border. Just specify your value, for example, 5. Save your changes, and here is the table with the border you specified. Okay, now let's take a look at table align over here. The name says it all here as well. You can left align, center, or right align your table. I'm gonna right align just to show you how it works. Save my modification. Now copy the code, go to your actual post. Make sure you are in text mode, paste here, update it, and check your post by clicking the view post link. You can see that the table is right aligned now. If I go back to my settings and change it to left, save my modification, go back to the post, refresh it. Now it's left aligned. All right, moving on to the next feature, and it's default theme. You can use the default theme drop-down to select your theme. For instance, you may want to select this one. Save your changes. Go to your post, refresh it. And here is the new theme applied to your table. It's pretty minimalistic. Like it says in the settings here. Alright, let's change it back to default. Now, the rest of the features over here are pretty advanced. And you'll need them only if you want to drastically edit the plugin. Since you need to be a programmer to do that, you know, to mess with the actual plugin, its advanced settings and so on, I'm sure that you'll be able to figure it out if you are a programmer. The last thing that I'd like to highlight is the ability to load CSV files. So make sure that your allow read CSV from file option is ticked. Now just go to the plugin page, scroll down to the very bottom, and copy this table from CSV file sample code. Just copy it, paste it to your post. Again, make sure that you are in text mode. And just replace this URL with yours. So you need to specify your actual CSV file path. Once you do, you'll be able to display the content from your CSV file right in your post. In other words, you will not have to manually copy and paste or manually enter every entry one by one. So it's really comfortable. In case you want to learn more, just go to the plugin page on wordpress.org. You can see more samples, more code that you can just apply for your cases and see what works better for you. The bottom line is that if it's not your first plugin, you know the drill. All right, hope it helps. Be sure to subscribe to the channel, like the video, and share via your social media accounts. Also, you can visit webdizzy.com for more stuff. Just click the link you can see on your screen right now. Thank you!